Hello friends, I hope you like my videos. So today we will discuss guidance for industry on 21 CFR part 11. So if you are having any question, you can ask me in the comment. Friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality. So please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standards and practices. So now in this slide we will discuss what is 21 CFR. So 21 CFR refers to a title 21 of the Code of Federal Regulations, which contains regulation issued by the Food and Drug Administration, that is FDA, of the United States Department of Health and Human Services, right? So 21 CFR is nothing but it's a kind of law for the United States, right? So like you can say in India there is a IPC code, that is Indian Penal Code, right? I hope you can now understand. So basically these regulations pertain to food and drug, and which cover a wide range of topics, which include food labeling, good manufacturing practices, and different kind of drug approval processes, medical devices, dietary supplements, and many more, right? So compliance with the 21 CFR is essential for companies which are operating in the food and pharmaceutical and medical devices industry to ensure the product safety, quality and efficacy in the United States market, right? So now what is part 11? So part 11 refers to title 21 CFR part 11, which is also known as electronic records, electronic signature, right? It is a regulation issued by the Food and Drug Administration, FDA, that established criteria for the acceptance of electronic records, electronic signature and handwritten signature executed to electronic records as equivalent to paper records and handwritten signature executed on paper, right? So you can understand like this. For example, if you are using the record in electronic format instead of hard paper, and using the signature electronically instead of manual signature with the pen, then part 11 regulation shall be applied, right? So basically 21 CFR part 11 applies to pharmaceutical, biotechnology and medical devices companies, and as well as other FDA regulated industries that choose to maintain records in electronic form instead of traditional paper formats, right? So basically it outlines the requirement for electronic record management system, electronic signature, and moreover the audit trial and validation of electronic system to ensure the data integrity and security and reliability of those data which are being generated by using the different of equipment, instrument and system that you are going to be used in your industry, right? So before going into the depth of 21 CFR part 11 guideline, we should know what is predicate rule. So the term predicate rule often specifically relates to the regulatory requirement that industries must meet in order to be marketed legally in the United States, right? So a predicate means you can say it's a kind of set of rule or law that we need to bound and we need to follow if we are working for the United States market, right? So now let's understand the part 11 background, that is when part 11 came into the picture, right? So in March of 1997, FDA issued final part 11 regulation that provide criteria for acceptance by FDA under certain circumstances of electronic record, electronic signature and handwritten signature executed to electronic record as equivalent to paper records and handwritten signature executed on paper. So basically part 11 talks about the using of electronic format of the record and the signature instead of the traditional one, which is the handwritten signature and paper based record, right? So part 11 became effective in August 1997. So now the major section in the guideline. So basically there are three major sections which are mentioned in this guideline. First one is overall approach to part 11 requirements. Second is details of approach and scope of part 11. Third is approach to specific part 11 requirements, right? So now we will first discuss about the section 8, that is overall approach to part 11 requirement. So what guideline recommending, that is we intend to enforce provisions related to the following controls and requirement. So first is limiting system access to authorized individuals. That means only authorized persons should have the access into the system, that may be from the user department and who shall use the system for the analysis purpose, or QA reviewer who shall review the electronic data, or maybe the user department head to approve the electronic data, and also the IT person who will going to manage the user management related activity, right? So next is use of operational system checks. So mainly user department is responsible to ensure the system is operational and performance is satisfactory throughout the life cycle of system, right? So operational checks may include but not limited to, that is monitoring the performance of system, ensuring the compliance, maintaining the reliability and maintenance of that system, right? So next is use of authority checks. So again, user department is responsible to ensure the right person are authorized to assess the system throughout the life cycle of system, right? So authority checks may include but not limited to, that is access control, compliance or risk management, etc. Next is use of device checks. So user department is responsible to ensure that system checks, which include but not limited to hardware inspection and operational maintenance, etc., right? Next is determination that person who develop, maintain or use electronic system have the education, training and experience to perform their assigned task. So whoever are going to use the system, that must be well educated, trained, experienced and qualified so that they can use the system, right? Next is establishment of and adherence to written policies that hold individual accountable for action initiated under their electronic signature. So policy should be in place for user management and using the individual electronic signature, right? And along with this, organization need to submit a letter on their letterhead with respect to the electronic signature to the FDA, right? So at the end of this video, I have explained about this letter, right? Next is appropriate controls over the documentation. So appropriate controls should be in place to ensure that documentation related to information system is accurate, secure, accessible and up to date, right? Which may include but not limited to, that is auditing and monitoring, backup and disaster recovery, regular reviews, encryption of the data, change management or training and awareness of that system to the user, right? Next is control for open system. So corresponding to control for closed system, bulleted above, right? So for open system, there should be more control which include the above what we discussed, right? So next is requirement related to electronic signature. So electronic signature requires must be fulfilled, that we already discussed, right? So now we will discuss the second section, that is details of approach for scope of part 11. So first is narrow interpretation of scope. So under the narrow interpretation of the scope of part 11, when persons choose to use records in electronic format in place of paper format, part 11 would apply, right? That means if you are using the records electronically, then part 11 predicate rule shall be applicable. On the other hand, when persons use computers to generate paper printout of electronic record and those paper records meets all the requirement of the applicable predicate rules and person rely on the paper records to perform their regulated activities, so FDA would generally not consider persons to be using electronic records in lieu of paper records. So here, for printed hard copy from computerized system, the part 11 predicate rule shall not be applicable, right? So now second is definition of part 11 records. records that are required to be maintained under predicate rule requirements and that are maintained in electronic format in place of paper format. So in this case, part 11 predicate rule shall be applicable, right? On the other hand, records that are not required to be retained under predicate rules but that are nonetheless maintained in electronic format are not part 11 required. For example, the hard copy, right? Records that are required to be maintained under predicate rules that are maintained in electronic format in addition to paper format and that are relied on the perform regulated activities, right? Electronic signatures that are intended to be the equivalent of handwritten signature, initials and other general signing required by predicate rules. So electronically signed will be considered as a part 11. So part 11 signatures include electronic signatures that are used for electronic document approval, review and verify, right? So now we will discuss third section, that is approach to specific part 11 requirement. So here first is validation. So guideline says, we suggest that your decision to validate computerized system and the extent of validation take into account the impact the system have on your ability to meet predicate rule requirement. So you need to perform the computerized validation which covers all the predicate rule requirements, right? Next is, you should also consider the impact those system might have an on the accuracy, reliability, integrity, availability and authenticity of required records and signatures. So overall, the data generated by using the system that should be authenticated, right? Second is audit trial. So specific part 11 requirements related to computer generated timestamped audit trials and any corresponding requirements. So audit trial should always be enabled and all the sequence of events should capture in the audit trial with respect to the correct time and date. Person must still comply with all applicable predicate rule requirements related to documentation, for example date, time or sequencing of events, as well as any requirements for ensuring that changes to records do not obscure previous entries. So if you are reprocessing any previous data, then integrity of previous data should also be maintained, that is traceability should be available for the original record or results, right? Now third is legacy system. The system was operational before the effective date. So operational qualification should be performed to ensure the operational condition of system prior to release the system for routine use, right? The system met all applicable predicate rule requirements before the effective date. So all part 11 predicate rule must be tested during the qualification. The system currently meets all applicable predicate rule requirement. So the system must comply all the time with applicable predicate rule, right? So you have documented evidence and justification that the system is fit for its intended use. So after computerized system validation, you must have either validation summary report of system or system release certificate that states the system is fit for its intended use, right? Fourth is copies of records. So producing copies of records held in common portable formats when records are maintained in these formats, so the data generated should be structured in a way that in portable format to proper visibility and easy to find, right? Using established automated conversion or export methods where available to make copies in more common format, for example, of such formats include but are not limited to, that is PDF, XML or HTML, right? Fifth is record retention. So the agency intends to exercise informed discretion with regards to the part 11 requirements for the protection of records to enable their accurate and ready retrieval throughout the records retention period. So you need to maintain the data throughout the data life cycle and that should be easily available whenever required, right? So now we will understand how the certificate statement for electronic signature will send to the FDA, right? So this statement should be made on the company letterhead. So here you need to provide the current date. This is the address of the FDA where you need to send the certificate statement, right? So this is the subject, and here you need to elaborate like to whom it may concern. The pursuant to section 11.100 of title 21 of the code of federal regulation, this is to certify that, here you need to mention the company name, intends that all electronic signatures executed by our employee agents or representatives located anywhere in the world are the legally binding equivalent to traditional handwritten signature. And here the handwritten signature of the company representative and the company representative, their designation you need to mention, right? So this format is also available on the FDA website. So this is the format by which you can send the your certificate statement related to electronic signature, right? So friends, this is all about the 21 CFR part 11 guideline. So I hope you can understand now. Thank you.